Hello! I recently got the request of a video explaining the basic Git commands you need to contribute to open source, so here we are. Disclaimer: this video is intended to be for developers with zero or very little Git knowledge, so I'm gonna oversimplify a little bit on some concepts. This will not be a complete Git tutorial, but rather a beginner guide on how to move the first steps with only the basic Git commands you need to contribute to open source and open your first pull request. To be fair, you could technically open a PR without writing a single command in the terminal, hence without using Git. Or at least you think you're not using Git, but you can use a user interface that underneath uses Git commands anyway. So running away from Git doesn't really make any sense, and I would expect a decent developer to know Git as it's a powerful and widespread tool you're gonna use every day. Anyway, enough introduction. Let's go on GitHub, go on the repository you selected, and create a fork of it. You can do so directly from GitHub with this fork button over here. As a result, GitHub will create an exact copy of that repository, but on your account. The reason is that you might not have access to the original repo, but for sure you have write access in your own local copy. The next step is downloading the fork on your local machine. The first Git command we see here is git clone. As the name suggests, this command downloads the code from a remote repository and creates a copy on your machine. The way we're going to use it here is git clone and then the URL of your repo that you can find on GitHub. It will be github.com/your name/the-repo-name.git. Once the download is complete, you will find yourself in the default branch. Every time you want to contribute to a repository, you better be in a separate branch. That's why we're going to introduce the next command, that is git checkout. This command allows you to move between branches, and if you add the option -b, it will create a new branch. So, git checkout -b feature /my-branch-name and hit enter. So, you're now in a separate branch of your local repository. That is the copy of a remote repository, that is the fork of someone else's repository. It might seem confusing at first, but you will get used to it. Actually, all we did was just pressing the fork button from GitHub, and then we downloaded our copy with clone, and we created a branch with checkout. It was just pretty simple and basic commands. Now, you can finally write your code, and once you're ready with all files saved, we can use the third git command, that is git add. To make it simple, git add tells what should be included in the next commit, and with git add dot, you actually include everything you've just modified. You can use git status to verify what is in the stage area, that is what will be used in the next command, git commit. Commit basically creates a checkpoint that identifies the difference between the previous state and the current one. Unless you specify the option M with a string right after, the terminal will ask you for a message. Be kind and write in a line or two what you just did. The sixth and final command you need is git push. And again, as the name suggests, it will push or say upload your commits to your remote repository. In case you get an error here, the terminal will tell you how to run this additional command. You can do it and push again. If you want to skip this step, I posted a short video explaining how, and you can go watch it later. With that done, we just saw all Git commands you really need to know to create a pull request on GitHub. There are only 6, so it's not that difficult, and I'm sure you can do that. From this point, in order to create a pull request, you just need to go back to the original repo, and GitHub will guide you to the final steps. And if you're confused, I also posted a short video with the pull request flow. Again, you can watch it later. As I mentioned in the beginning, you can actually do everything without writing git commands in the terminal, for example with a GUI or graphical user interface, as it could be GitHub desktop. But that's not the point here. You can let me know in the comments if you'd like me to record a video where I tell you how to use the GitHub desktop tool, because it's quite handy. But I'd really like you to experiment with Git and get used to the commands written in the terminal. In case you have more questions, feel free to drop a comment down below. I'd be really happy to answer or even record new video if you have some specific requests, like this video. And for those of you who didn't know me, my name is Leonardo and I'm a web developer, and I like to talk here about open source and obviously web development. So feel free to subscribe to my channel if you're interested in videos like this one about open source and Git development, the topics I talk about. Now, before going to watch a proper Git tutorial, make sure you're using tutorials the right way. In this other video here, I try to tell you what is tutorial hell and why so many beginner developers are struggling in moving their first step in development and even in open source. So feel free to leave a like on this video and see you in the other video.